Oh God! The pain.
What happened? Were you bit?
Oh yes, snake bit, just like you.
Attack!
Land. No more. You're going back north where you belong. We are ridding the end of your kind for good.
Look what I caught.
We've got you.
This little heat can hit you.
Gonna feed the worms.
Blindside the poxy runt!
Suffer!
Hit now!
Go on!
Come on, the food's getting cold.
God damn you!
Eivor! What news?
Your father is dead.
Wait, what?
The sigil of Hunbjorg's house. I found it near his body.
No. No, this cannot be. He was strong, a pillar of Lincolnshire. He cannot be gone.
Oh, you poor boy. I'm so, so sorry.
I am a man, Archer. Do you hear me? I am a man and I am my father's son. Do not forget it.
He has been dead for some time. That was obvious by the state of his corpse. One of you knows more than you're letting on.
I'm sorry, Hunwald. I had already asked a priest to administer last rites when your father disappeared.
What?
I didn't tell you sooner because I thought by some miracle he had survived.
You lied to me!
You silly, sobbing mooncalf. Will you never grow up?
Lord have mercy on that woman. She should have said something. It was her duty to say something.
Hunwal was the son of an elderman. Will he take his father's seat?
The title's not hereditary, but he can plead his case before a shire moot. King Ceolwulf must then ratify the decision.
Explain how this works, your shire moot.
A moot is a meeting of lords. We convene from time to time to steer the course of our shire.
It was always my intention to convene a moot, but between our troubles in Lincoln and the bandits' raids, we slipped into a pattern of convenience.
Hunwald is an obvious candidate, but I don't trust any of you beyond the tip of a spear. I'll see to it that he's protected until your shire moot gathers.
None here wishes the boy ill, but do what you think necessary.
Apart from Hunwald, who else will stand for the Elderman's seat?
If I may be so bold, I should like to put my name forward. Under my care, this shire has found some peace this past month.
I will offer my name as well. My family has ancient ties to this land. And I am proud to say I have forged quite a friendship with the Danes to the north.
Good. My priests will spread word of the moot across the Shire, and we'll convene in a few days' time.
Do visit my estate, Eivor. I have something for you. Something I think you'll enjoy.
I'll find the time.
Eivor, a word, if you don't mind.
Is the word Christ or pagan?
Oh, I deeply regret my churlish ways when we first met. I did not treat you as my God commands, with kindness and love.
Love is a difficult feeling to command.
Yes, quite. In any case, thank you for putting this mystery to rest. I do hope we'll see you at the moot.
With Hunbjorth's death an open secret, Hunwald's enemies may strike again. I should find him before they do.
Archer went to console him. I should follow her.
Archer, where is Hunwald?
I tried to console him, but he pushed me away. I love the boy, I do. But I fear what would happen if he took his father's title. He's fragile and scattered. I saw him ride north, following the paved Roman road, to the old tall tree where he often passed time with his father, I imagine.
Hunwald loved you like family, and you lied to his face.
In my way, I was trying to protect him. Oh, St. Cuthbert, give me strength.
Oaths and ale work better than your prayers and saints. Sunan, guide me.
Here, upon this spot. Eivor, what a pleasant surprise. Would you drink with me?
Hunwald.
Come, sit. Stay with me a while and contemplate the view.
Collect yourself, Hunwald. There's many a man in Lincolnshire who'd pay to see your head on a pike.
Well, they can wait a moment.
Do not gorge on grief, nor give in to sadness. But let your aching love light the mead of your eyes and lead you to triumph.
That is quite lovely. My father would have liked you. He liked all those who could swing a sword and speak a verse with ease.
He had a large heart and a love for his people. I think I would have liked him too.
He and I used to wander up this way all the time. He would take me hunting. And I would catch the most wretched little things if I caught anything at all. I was a rubbish hunter. But he always said he was proud. Each and every time.
A toast. To your father, Lord Hunbjorth of Lincolnshire. He may have dwindled from this world in death, but in life he was a stalwart as this tree.
A wise old oak. Yes.
Skull.
Skull. And then my father says it's the right goat, but it's the wrong end. Oh, my Swanborough loves that one. She has a great sense of humour, my lady love. Father would have liked her.
Right. Your Dane lady love, she sounds lovely. Too lovely to be real.
You know what? We should visit her. We should go to Grimsby. Yes, there's no time to lose.
After you.
Nothing like drinking and riding to jostle your troubles away.
And the contents of your gut. What do you see, Sunan?
Now come and enjoy the splendor of my shire.
You Saxons and your tiny splendor. You have never seen mountains, have you? Or deep fjords like a giant's axe wound. Or towering falls that steam in the dead of winter. Snow sparkling like a blanket of jewels. That is splendor.
Well, if your homeland is so splendorful, why come to England at all?
You cannot grow crops on a blanket of jewels.
Very true.
I'll admit, your countryside does take the breath away.
Quite so. I love this land. And should I follow my father's footsteps, I shall do my solemn duty to protect her. I know many think me foolish, inexperienced, but I would ask that they judge me by my future hopes, not my past reputation. If I am given sway over this land and show myself to be a poor leader, shame me, punish me, of course, but give me that chance. By God, I just want to have that chance.
What was that?
Birds, Eivor. Has no one told them today is a day of grief?
Stop here. Something isn't right. I'll find the trouble before it finds us. Survey the area, Sunan.
Hey!
That's twice they tried to kill you, Hunwald.
And twice failed.
We had luck, but if you're not more careful, they will succeed. Someone in Mercia wants you dead, and they'll kill anyone in the way to see it done.
Yes, including my dear Swanborough, my lady love. Come, let us hurry away.
I am serious, Hunwald. Are you hearing me?
Plain and clear. Follow me.
Hunwald, are you sure this place is safe?
The safest spot in the Shire, yes. Here I am with a chance to be Elderman, but I have yet to prove myself worthy. To you, to the Shire, to her. I can do nothing without my darling lady. You've made me realize how much I've neglected her through this fatal stupor of mine.
This I must see for myself.
I thought for sure you'd be dead. Why didn't you send word?
It has been far too long, my little jewel. I'm so very sorry for that.
I'm fine, my love. I wilted without you, but still I grow. And who is this?
Ah, yes. I am proud to present Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Hello, Eivor. A pleasure to meet you.
And you, Swanborough. I wasn't sure what to make of Hunwald's stories, yet here you are.
Surprised to find a Dane by his side?
Not quite. I'm surprised to find a Saxon at yours. Hunwald seems to endear himself to all sorts.
Eivor agreed to help me find my father. But I'm afraid it hasn't gone as well as I'd hoped.
What's happened?
My father is dead. Died of a cruel disease, apparently. Then shunted off to a cellar for burial.
Oh, my love, I'm sorry.
And someone in your shire wants to make sure Hunwald follows his father to the grave.
Let them try. I'll cut their throats.
A shire moot will soon be held. Hunwald should stay here out of sight until he can attend.
What if I left it all behind, my love? Forget my father's seat. What if I stayed here with you? Just the two of us.
Hunwald, no. This Shire must be led with courage and heart. Follow in your father's footsteps and lead the Shire as he did.
Whatever strength you lack, you have in Swanborough. Heed her advice.
Yes. If anyone can lift my spirits in time for the Shire moot, it's you, my dear.
Come inside and rest your bumbling bones, love. Be well, Eivor, and thank you.
Keep watch over that one. Men have come for him more than once.
My blade will keep him safe.
I do not doubt it.
Eivor, welcome to my estate, old friend.
Thane Alfgar, it's an impressive amount of land you oversee.
Quite right. I often get lost swimming to my island in this flowing sea of wheat.
You're flush with land and crops, to be sure. You're a brave man to flaunt your riches from this lonely hill.
It's not bravery, it's trust. I trust the respect I've earned keeps Saxon and Dane alike from temptation.
You said you had something to show me when we last spoke. What did you mean?
Yes, I did. Observe. This fine specimen belonged to our beloved elderman, Hunbeort, before his untimely passing. He left it here when we last hunted together. I now wish you to have it.
It is a beautiful weapon. Finally crafted. Thank you.
I thought you might like it. Now, take it and come hither. I have a rousing hunt planned for the two of us. Leave aside talk of politics and shire moats. Let us enjoy the fruits of my land together.
We're hunting or fruit picking?
Both, if you like. Whatever you fancy. I'm generous with the yields of my estate, as you will see. To be plain, Eivor, a great bear has been badgering my estate for weeks. I must do away with it, if only to prevent a future tragedy.
You brought me here to hunt a bear.
Yes, and I'm so pleased you agreed to... still teems with life, with promise. But today, Shire languishes. It needs the guidance of new blood.
Like me.
I'm sorry?
I'm the definition of new blood. It may be I should put my name in for Elderman.
Ah, there it is, that dark sense of humor. Blunt as a hammer, eh? Like the one carried by your thunder god. I don't recall the name.
Go on.
What I mean to say is, I enjoy the company of your people. Or people like you, what little I've seen of them. And I don't care what stuffy fools like Herefriv and Hunwald say. You Danes are damn decent people. Not dense at all.
Kind of you to notice.
I remember when the Danes first arrived, not long ago. The locals were terrified, not of being raided.
Are we hunting, Elfgar? Or is it your hope that I'll braid your hair?
Hunting, definitely. The bear's lair should be nearby. Ah, my old friend Grimm. How wonderful to see you here. What a pleasant surprise.
What surprise? I came as you requested.
Yes, and how is Grimsby? How are all the other Danes?
I can't speak for all Danes, but I am well, and itching for a hunt, as you made plain in your message this morning.
Yes, that's right, very good. Speaking of Danes, I'd like to introduce you to Eivor. Perhaps you know each other as one Dane to another.
It is good to meet you, Grim.
Hey, Eivor. Did he lure you here as well with the promise of a hunt?
He...
Yes, hunting a bear! That's the point of all this. We're hunting, I promise.
There's a cave just up the hill there. Seems a likely place for a lair.
If the beast is as large as Elfgar claims, it'll take all three of us to bring it down.
I'm game. Let's get a new fur cloak, shall we? There's all manner of beasts in this forest. If we don't find the bear, we'll find something worth our supper.
I have a divine rule over the land on my estate. God shall provide. Have no worry.
This is the threshold of a beast's home. There's no doubting that. That's not a bear. Wolves. Soon to be a sea of fire.
Eivor! You're skilled enough, and I can't tell you how to handle this, but... Please! My God, help me with this!
I'm in this fight with you! A clutch of puny Mercians don't frighten me!
Best not to draw attention here.
Und da ist jetzt der Willard Spiller! advantage.
Too, brother.
The men who would see you burn are dead. Let's get these fires out.
Agreed.
What a mess. A sea of ashes. I thank you, Eivor, for doing what you could.
You're a man of many riches, Alvgar. You can rebuild.
To be sure. But I do not look forward to the toilet. Sweet Lord in heaven! The bear is returned!
The Shiremut will start soon. I should return to Lincoln to see that it goes well.
Yeah.
Archer, is everything ready?
The Shire Moot will soon begin. Will you join us, Eivor? We'd be comforted by your presence.
Yes, I'm curious to see this Shire Moot for myself. I will follow.
When will the vote begin, Abbess?
12 able lords of Lincolnshire have already cast their stones, but they have reached a tie. 4 votes for each man. It now falls to you to break this impasse.
Me? By whose order?
You have earned the trust of our 3 candidates, it seems. Even our bishop has found a certain fondness for your hardy spirit.
It's an important vote for your people. How would you counsel my vote?
I value competent and righteous leadership, not foolish friends in high seats.
Anyone but Hunwald, you mean?
I love Hunwald as I love my own kin. But I would not put a stone in his care without fearing for the safety of both. I pray that God guides your vote today, and not the devil, as I fear.
King Ceolwulf's attendant, aren't you?
Aye. The king sends his love and support. Whatever happens here today shall have his full blessing.
He's learning fast. Good man.
Thy beast was learned a better mule in
A vote for Hunwald will return the house of the ferocious swan to its...
How fare you, lord?
My prayers are fervent and my will is strong, Eivor. If I am Elderman, I will bring joy to this Shire.
There is more to good leadership than merrymaking. You must be strong and stern and willing to take risks.
Of course, of course. Strength and wisdom and fortitude and all that. I shall rise above the peat moss of mediocrity. Have no fear.
That is good to hear.
A vote for Hunwald will return the house of the ferocious swan to its former glory.
Bishop.
Eivor, I must thank you for your fearless participation in our moot.
I'm surprised to hear you vouched for me, Bishop.
I surprised myself, to be honest. But I felt it would be a good test of God's faith in my judgment. Under my guidance, this Shire is crawling back from a decade of lawlessness. God knows the love that lives in my heart for the people of Lincolnshire. I pray now that he guides your hand accordingly.
Quite a gambit, Bishop. Mad enough to work, it may be.
Well then, I thank you for what it's worth. God go with you.
How are you, Lord?
Have I heard aright that you have come to break us from our deadlock?
I have, Lord. Have you any advice before I vote?
Lord Hundbeor was a bold and honest man, if somewhat reckless. I see the same qualities in his son. Therefore, Hunwald is my man.
Grim, good to see you again.
A hearty hello, Drengir. Seems Britain is getting quite used to the idea of Danes stalking her shores.
Where do you fall in this contest, Grim? Alfgar is a friend of yours, is he not?
He is, and a good man as well. But I cast my stone for the bishop.
The bishop? That's an odd strategy.
These Christians are easy to nudge about. So desperate they are to avoid a good fight, they'll agree to most anything a Dane says.
Good evening, Alfgar.
Eivor, I hope it's not untoward of me to solicit your support, but I do need it. The vote is closer than a cat's whisker.
It is a difficult choice, Alfgar. Know that I won't make it lightly.
Good, good. But let me say unreservedly that I am the man who will lead Lincolnshire into progress and victory.
I do not doubt your convictions, Lord. Free men, free possible futures.
Which of these sad puppets will dance best when you call upon them?
It is not for myself I must cast the stone, but for my clan. Who will serve us best in a time of true need?
You can never be certain where you stand in another's heart. Choose only for yourself.
All three have strengths and weaknesses. Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever, but he has heart and spirit. Both go a long way in times of need. Lead your Shire with pride, ferocious swan.
It is decreed by this lawful Shire Moot that the Eldermen of Lincolnshire shall be son of our dear and departed Lord Hundbjor, Lord Hunwald of Lincolnshire.
I don't know what to say. I thank you deeply, madly, humbly. What more can I say? I don't know. I miss my father. I'd sooner see him standing here than... Well, I will do my best for each and every one of you.
Let us all raise our cups. A toast to our new Eldermen. As all well know, this Shire Moot's decision is not final, but advisory. It now falls to our newly anointed King Teowulf to ratify our choice. To this end, we need not worry. Teowulf is a friend to Saxon and Dane alike, and he is sure to approve the results. Our good and noble friend, Arthelswith.
The septic rot has overtaken this Shire. A sickness for which there is only one cure.
Your Grace! What is this?
Nobles of Lincolnshire, stand fast!
For the glory of the ancients, leave none alive!
Steel yourself, Lord.
Mother of God! Another battle!
Here we go!
This one's gone. Find those who still draw breath. Polish your ass, Hunwald. The Elderman's seat is yours. As your war council, I suggest you...
We should first bury our dead, no?
That choice is yours to make, Elderman.
Yes. Yes, of course. We'll bury our dead, then raise a feared.
I am at a loss for words. A trusted man of the cloth. I will pray for these martyrs, and tend to the remaining wounded until the last man walks free.
Be well, Archer.
And you, Eivor. May God or the gods protect you.
Gibeon, come forth in Dos Septimor. Diluc gloelec, nerve spertem posiponan,
esbit
biacquos a paterna sum, tales enem voluntantum te.
Dominus!
Bold attack, and in broad daylight. The hatred that eats at that man must be ravenous.
What news, Hunwald?
We've learned that Herivrith rode for the fort at Anicastre following the massacre. I have assembled a fyrd there. Quite a large one, in fact. They eagerly await your orders, Eivor.
You mean your orders, Elderman?
Ah, yes, that's right. My orders. Which are what, exactly?
Who can say? Ride with me to your camp, and we'll find out together.
Herivrith was a friend of my father's, and always so dear to me. I don't understand what possessed him.
He invoked the name of an ancient order before his men attacked. I know exactly what possessed him.
Do you?
It's not a story for now.
This will send waves of disgust through all the parishes of Mercia. Herifrith is a new and ugly stain on the bishopric.
Your Christ was an interesting man, if a little soft. But stranger still, I've met so few Christians like him.
Today has been a boon, Eivor. In spite of everything, I now know my father's spirit still burns within me. It's thanks to you I know this. When songs are sung of the day Lincolnshire was saved, your name will ripple through every stanza.
Don't be hasty, Hunwald. One verse of our song remains unsung. The din of battle beckons.
You pagans and your appetite for battle. I certainly don't share it. I worry what diabolical feast the bishop has in store.
Don't let that poxy bishop worry you. With Eivor beside us, he'll be victuals before long. How has Atcha taken all this? She and Herivrith were so close.
She must feel as though the devil himself attacked her monastery. The poor lady.
We spoke briefly. Her spirits were low, but her word carried on. I think she'll be fine.
Manipulated by a man who should be God's gladdener.
We are the men of Lincoln.
What? I'm walking here, shit. Here's the camp, do you see? The fyrd will soon be ready for action.
Give them mead and let them rest. There is hard fighting ahead.
Our warsmith has arrived. The fyrds are ready to fight.
Chieftain Eivor, can we win this fight with the men you see assembled here?
If they fight with the bravery of double their number, we may.
And is there room in your Valhalla for a ferocious swan?
Of course. Let fly your glorious banner.
Are we ready then?
We attack now. Ready the fyrd.
Our first task will be to breach the outer wall. Then we deal with the troops inside.
Give them mead and let them rest. There is hard fighting ahead. The best way to breach is with a battering ram. I should help it along.
Let us lose.
Point me to the bishop. No one else need die today.
He's in the chapel there, hiding away. Scabrous coward.
Let no one leave that church without facing judgment. Get on the other side. Thank you.
died the day I hid behind these robes, this cross. To bring the light of my order to a wider view, I did baste myself. Clawed my way to the top of this common religion, full of common men. I should have lived as the ancients did.
That's the folly of mankind, Herifrith. We wallow in our failures, like happy pigs in a sty of shit. We should have learned to enjoy it.
Eivor, is he... is the bishop dead?
He bled too little and talked too much. Now he's gone.
I won't miss him. But Atcha will need some time to grieve.
You fought well, ferocious swan. Notched a few scars in your baby fat today.
Yes, but they will heal. And stronger than before.
Lincolnshire is yours to lead, Elderman. The hardest fight begins now.
The din of battle still rings in my ears. I think I now know what it means to be a leader.
Good.
I would ask a favor, if I could.
Name it.
As Elderman, my life may be a dangerous one. For a time, anyway.
Would you allow my Swanborough to take refuge in your settlement? At least until I feel all danger has passed.
We'd be happy to have her.
Thank you, my sturdy Norse berserker. The mead halls of my shire will be lonely without you stomping about.
Our people are bonded now. We must look out for one another.
Blast it! I am a horror with goodbyes.
It'll do for now.
Now it seems the wind calls me back to Ranvi. Best tell her the good news. Go, Sunan.
You look well.
Lincolnshire is a friend to us.
Wonderful news. And who is our ally there?
The boy Hunwald is the new Elderman of Lincolnshire, and he has sworn allegiance to us.
The Loud One, an Elderman? Well, should he ever wish to call for aid, he need only shout.
But Ragnarsson has come. He claims to have some business with you.
Uba Ragnarsson, you're a long way from your king's side.
Eivor. Yes, a long stroll through the hills and fields of Mercia. Also, I could thank you.
Thank me?
For sending my brother to his just reward. In spite of the harm he caused you and everyone around you, I could not keep him in line in this life. But I have no doubt the old father will put him to good use in the next.
A darkness followed your brother, one I am not sure he understood. But as you say, he is now where he belongs.
He is. And this is...
Thank you.
Put it to good use, Wolfkist. And may we meet again.